Okay, folks, this week something completely different. As we have probably seen in the video title, we have an alpha preview of a game called Kingdoms and Castles. This is a game I backed using a service called Fig. Now it's a sort of like a software only version of Kickstarter, but they only deal with decent studios who are almost guaranteed to deliver you a product and not just take your money for cocaine and hookers. Oops, sorry, my cynical side coming out again there. Bad Master Lich. But I digress. This game is like a 4X game on a more intimate scale. You are the king of a small kingdom, and your hard working but loyal peasants, as usual, do all the work, of course. Some things never change. You have advisors if you need them on hand. The graphics are in the blocky style. I have to admit, the game seems to be an almost up-to-date version of Populous, but on a smaller scale, as I said. You start off, as usual, with nothing. You have to build up all your infrastructure of your kingdom to gather all your basic needs like wood, stone, iron to build things, and of course feed to feed your workers, or they get grumpy and die. Throughout a year cycle, just like real life, time can be controlled, unlike real life, by pausing the game, and you can issue orders in this mode, and then you can either restart it or speed time up if you want to. Sound is both used very well, using great medieval style music, providing you with fantastic ambience, and Spock sound effects are used very well, you know, like chopping trees down, or the sound of sort of breaking stone in quarries, etc. Now I think both are very pleasant, and you don't want to turn off the sound because it makes your ears bleed after a few minutes. Music varies enough so it never gets boring, unlike some games I could mention. Graphics, I said, are both blocky Minecraft sort of style, but very much their own and very cute. The menus and basic control of the game are both logical and well laid out. Very much, you know, single click to put down, or click on an object to tell someone how to interact with it. So, you find this particular video after me muck around for around about 30 minutes finding out how the basic game works in my first session, and of course I'm still learning here, but the learning curve is very well presented and never frustrating, so that was very well done as well. All in all, I can state that I really enjoy this game, and I recommend you keep an eye out on your gaming service of choice for Kingdoms and Castles, and put it on your game purchase list as soon as it comes out, be it with a Steam, GOG, etc. It's, as I stated, currently in alpha, progressing well, and should be out later this year as it's currently scheduled. But I will do another complete review when it's available to purchase, and even better, as it's not a AAA price game, it's even better for you folks. Well, please enjoy me sucking up and messing about as usual, destroying simple things and getting things completely wrong as normal, this side. Some things never change. do they, folks? Well, you know as old gets. So, take it easy, and please enjoy my gameplay. It's time for MasterlitchUK to sign off. Thank you.
Thank you.